Hi everyone, Namaste. Namaste is the word used in our country Nepal to greet someone. Me, Rupak Nepali. In our second video, we installed OpenCart and is now up and running at our custom URL webcreation.log. Today, in our third video, I'm going to describe files and folders of OpenCart framework. First thing we do is look through the files and folder structure. So this files and folder structure is of OpenCart 2.2 and which is similar in OpenCart 3 as well. The only distinct folder structure that I see in terms of modules are they put modules inside the extension folder. Other than that, it looks similar in terms of modules developer. So now let's talk about the admin folder. Admin folders has its own controller folder, language folder, module folder, and view folders. If you are developing for the admin sections, then these are the folders you are going to touch. In catalog folder, similar, you get the controller language, modules, and module and view that holds all front-end style files and folders. We'll discuss in details about these folders when we start making Hello World modules. The another folder which contains cache folder, catalog folder, and payment folder with no image.png, placeholder.png, and profile.png. Placeholder and no images are used if there are no images found. For example, let's go to the category page. Let's see. So all desktop. So you will see this product 8, which has no images, no main images. So it's gives the placeholder.png images. Now how? Catalog folder contains many images which we upload either from backend or the front end, like category image, product image, images inserted from the text area, etc. Let's take an example. Like let's say we want to add an image for the categories. Let's say we upload an image for this category. Let's image and let's create a new folder called camera. Cameras. Directory is created. Let's go inside the cameras. Let's upload an image. File is uploaded. And let's select it. And let's, before saving, let's check here. So you create a camera folders in here. Wait, that is created there. Now camera folder is created here. So whatever images you uploaded, it will be stored in here. So what the cache folder do is whatever we resize for the main image, then it will be cached in here. So this one is like 100 by 100 size image, because the thumbnails that it created here, this one is 100 by 100. So let's go to the front end where the cameras, So when you see this one, these images is 80 by 80. So you see it creates when it loads. So it's like 80 by 80. So next time it will just directly take from this cache folder. Like this way, images are handled in the image folder. So there is another install folder which I already deleted. So that install folder contains OpenCart.sql file which create tables on a specified database and insert demo data. Other files have a code which facilitates to install OpenCart. System folder is the base where OpenCart framework is defined. It contains config folder, engine, helper, libraries, and storage folders. We'll provide details of these folders in next video with the code flow. And another is htaccess.txt is a configuration file used on web server running the Apache web server software, where you rename the htaccess.txt to only .htaccess. Mostly we use this for the issue URL redirects in OpenCart. If you are using NGX, then NGX have its own way, but for Apache web server, we use htaccess to write all these redirects, which is given by the OpenCart directly. And other file is config.php, where constant is defined and is different as per the installation. Then in index.php, where we can find what version of OpenCart we are using and start of the application, which we will define in next videos. Last one is php.ini, which is the configuration file for running application. It is used to control variables, something like this magic code, gpc register, globals, default characters, memory limit, maximum execution time, and many others. I found that share hosting doesn't provide these facilities to change it from here, but if you are using private servers, then you can set to use them. As per the module development, this will be the file if as per the module development, I just create a basic file structures that I want to show to you guys. So this left hand shows files and folder structures that we need to place our files for modules development. So this is in OpenCart 2 and this is on OpenCart 3 on the right hand side. So only changes that we see is the controller modules, but here it's a controller extension and modules. So we need to create in controller language view and in catalog controller language view. Same follows in OpenCart 2.2 as well. Okay, so our third video is completed. Hope you like it. As always, please don't forget to post your questions or comments so that I can add extra topics or things that I need to develop, which will help me to develop quality of a video series. You can follow at my Twitter account RupakNPL and subscribe our YouTube channel Online Gyan Nepal. Similarly, keep on visiting my personal blog webcreation.com, where you can find a lot of free modules. In next video, I will show you OpenCart framework code flow, so don't miss it. As if you understand these flows, then you can start coding without seeing other videos. So see you in next videos and happy learning, and thanks for watching and liking my videos. See you.